My name is Volker Sommer. I'm a professor of evolutionary anthropology at University College London, and as such, I study humans and other animals. I often come across an argument which goes, oh, God created Adam and Eve, but he didn't create Adam and Steve. And for that reason, homosexuality is against nature and very wrong. African politicians, Catholic priests, and Muslim clerics alike will make that argument, and I examined it together with a colleague of mine, Paul Wasey, and we looked into what's happening in nature, and we found that homosexual behavior in animals is actually quite common. You can see it in flamingos, in geese, in cats, in bisons, and dolphins, and monkeys, and apes such as gorillas, or the famous bonobo chimpanzees. Here, females will engage in what is called GG rubbing. They rub their clitoris against each other, and they seem to really like it. Like in bonobos, in many other animal societies, sex is used as a social tool. It's not always a straightforward, straight function of reproduction. It is also a means of making friends, of giving texture to the social fabric, of rewarding friendship, and so on, because sex, if it's good sex at least, is pleasurable. So those who criticize, however, homosexuality based on their idea of nature will say, oh, hang on a second, clearly these animals which do it, they must be deprived of access to the opposite sex, which is simply not true. For example, Japanese macaques, a certain type of monkey, here females will, in the presence of motivated and available males, choose to have homosexual sex with females of their group by rubbing their genitals along the back of their group mates. The other counter argument would be, oh, clearly it's not a lifelong relationship, which again is not true because, for example, in geese, there are certain male pairs who will stay together for life. Finally, the argument is, oh yes, but that has nothing to do with human homosexuality because that is only homosexual behavior. These animals are clearly not fantasizing about having sex with members of their own sex. Again, it's unlikely that this argument is true because, for example, in the cattle rearing industry, there is a phenomenon called the Buller's deer syndrome, and it means that there are certain males who will only get sexually excited if they see other males. And if you put them in front of an artificial vagina so that they can deposit their sperm, they will not do it. And I always suggest that they should have some proper male porn, you know, a real big stud, like cattle guy on the screen, and then maybe they will do the hetero thing without realizing. Now, what about the argument that homosexuality is against nature and those who may be willing to listen to the facts found by science? Well, they will often not listen. They will just turn it around and they will say, well, yes, maybe homosexual behavior is found in nature, but humans are not animals. After all, we should rise above our primitive drives and we should be cultivated beings and get rid of our animalistic roots. So, however you present the argument, those who want to argue against homosexuality and use nature, they will find a way. You could also, of course, propagate homosexuality. And you could say, yeah, now science tells us that homosexual behavior occurs in animals other than humans, so it's a good thing. Dolphins do it, bonobos do it, let's do it. Whether or not a behavior occurs in nature doesn't tell us if we should morally condone it or condemn it. There is a lot of stuff which, let's say, we like mothers taking care of their infants, food sharing, cooperation, but there is a lot of stuff which our contemporary moral code wouldn't condone, such as rape, cheating, infanticide, warlike conflicts between groups. David Hume, the philosopher, made this argument a long time ago, and he called it the naturalistic fallacy. If people say that there is a straight route from the natural is to the moral ought, he said, well, there isn't. Whether something occurs in nature or not doesn't tell us whether or not it is good or bad. So, at least we can say that those who say that homosexuals act against nature, that those who make that argument, that they are wrong. And of course, we can also say that same-sex sexual behavior is one of the multiple colors of nature's rainbow. Whether or not we do not like a certain color, or we like a certain color, well, that's really up to us.